What is up, hustlers? Now that we're almost ready, we're finally almost ready to set your store live, which is going to be very exciting. There's a few more things and quick tricks, tips, and hacks that I'm going to run you through before you set your store live. And this is very important and very simple changes to the overall Shopify platform on the back end that will basically boost your chances of making your first sale. So very exciting stuff. And by the way, this is a rehash of a previous video that I've done in the past, but it is very useful for the people that are following on this beginner's tutorial series to watch this. So let's get into it right now. Let's go.
But no bulls in the house, the blues. It's the
now in the back end of my test Shopify store. So what you see is a basic store with all the default settings. And like I said, very simple changes, but very important. So let's get stuck right into it. All right, so let's go into the front end of my store. And here you see my very inexpensive, very modest looking test shirt for $9,001. What a lot of people don't do, I realize, is shipping and taxes calculated checkout. They don't remove this. And this is very important to either remove or manage differently. So how to change this is very simple. Go into the back end of the Shopify store. What you do now is search for language, type in language, go into the checkout settings, go all the way down, until we hit manage checkout language, click on that. And the top of the tabs, once it loads, click on cart. From cart, you wanna scroll down and find shipping and taxes calculated at checkout. What you'll need to do simply is just remove this. If you wanna remove this completely, just remove it. What I do, however, is I run frequent free shipping deals. So what I like doing is typing in free shipping included, hit save. Now go back into the front end and refresh the page. Now you see here, completely changed the free shipping included, which is so much more appealing, guys, because it's just one less step or one less sort of hindrance to the customer. Because, you know, ultimately, if they're seeing that there's going to be taxes and shipping calculated after adding to cart, it's just basically another hindrance affecting conversion rate. So a very simple change, but very important. The other thing that a lot of people don't change either is the Powered by Shopify link here. We want to remove that. And Shopify is going to hate me for saying this, but basically, you know, it links out to the Shopify store, and that's just basically useless for us. We want people to stay on our website so they're able to convert. So some coding involved here, but very simple. I'll run you through it very slowly. So if you want to remove this, all you need to do is go into online store and themes, click on themes, click actions, click edit code. So in the sections folder, we want to look for footer. It's under the sections folder, click footer. All you need to do is hit Control F, bring up the finder bar. All you need to look for is footer. Sorry, not that, powered. So look for powered. You see this little code here. All you need to do is just remove that, simple as that, delete. Hit save, and now you refresh the page, voila, it's gone. And now it's looking so much more professional. So those two very quick amendments already looking very fresh, looking so much more professional, and it's definitely gonna help with your conversion rates. Now, let's go into something a little bit more advanced, but just as important. Let's go into the product page. So I'll click onto the product itself, the test shirt. What we want to do, everyone knows about trust badges, we want to add them below the add to cart button. That way there's a sense of security, there's a sense of credibility. Go into the back end of your store once again, and this time you want to look for product template. So just type in product go into product template underneath sections, guys. Click on that. Now you simply want to look for add to carts with spaces, sorry. Well, sometimes it's without. Add to cart. There we go. Perfect. So this is the code that you want to find. After that, you just want to go underneath div. From here, what you want to do is basically just type in div again. And close the div here. For all you coding newbies, div is just a container element to separate the items on a HTML document. So once you've typed in div, what you want to do now, usually what you have to do is upload the Trustpad images into CDN on Shopify, and that's just too tedious. So what I've done is upload the link and created the link myself just to make it super easy for you guys. So let's go into this document here. This is the link, and what I'll do is post this link directly in the description box below this video to make it very easy for you guys. Just copy and paste this. Copy, paste, hit save. Now let's take a look, refresh this page. There we go, guys, perfect. So what we see here is a very great looking, very, very appealing looking trust badge. It's got all your usual trust badges in there. So already looking so much better, guys, very quick changes. But what we wanna do now, since we've added the trust badge, what we wanna do is manipulate the add to cart button code, because obviously, what dominates this page, what draws the attention of the customer, is the trust badges. And although that's great, that's not what we want. We want the attention to be on the add to cart, so people are able to add to cart. Now, this is going to be a little bit more complex, but still relatively simple because I'll run you guys through it very slowly. Go back into the backend. This time, what you want to look for is theme.css. It's under assets, click on that. So you want to find theme.scss.liquid. And again, fun fact for you coding newbies out there, Liquid is the type of code that Shopify owns and runs. So now that we're in this, look for link and button styles. So just try looking for button styles, both with S's. What you want to do is scroll down underneath this section, just above the next section. From here, what you want to do is type in hashtag add to carts, open bracket, enter. Now, this is where we're going to sort of modify the size of the button. So you want to type in width, semicolon. This is where you sort of play around with it, guys. I'm going to go with maybe 320 pixels, px. Close it. Hit save. Now, let's take a look. Refresh the page. There we go, guys. It's looking better, but I think it could be a bit longer depending on your website. So all you have to do basically is just change the pixel count. Let's change it to maybe 360. Hit save again. Refresh the page. There we go. Basically, it's looking really good. Obviously, it might go to about 380 or 400, but you just want to experiment, play with it, so your website looks really, really great, basically, incredible. So those are basically the changes that I wanted to show you. Actually, while I'm at it, let's just quickly go into the checkout settings page. There's a few very quick things here that I want to run you through that, again, a lot of people don't do for some reason. Running through these very valuable settings, you want to go into customer accounts, Hit accounts are optional because basically we want to make it easy for people to check out, but at the same time, we want to basically acquire the email addresses and the details so they can come back to the site. So that's the best option for that. Skip that. I usually hit require last name only. Again, just to make it as simple for the customer to check out. Company name is hidden. And everything else is hidden. I actually hide address line 2 because that's kind of useless. This is quite useful, guys. By default, customer agrees to receiving promotional emails. That's awesome because that's a psychological thing. Again, most people don't bother to check these things, so they agree to receiving promotional emails, which is great for your email database. That's basically it, guys. Oh, the final thing, of course, is generating these refund policies, privacy policies in terms of service. Shopify has this really neat tool where you can generate really quick policies. And this is really useful. I really recommend it just while you're starting out, just to cover your back. That's about it, guys. So, you know, relatively very quick, simple things to do, but ultimately helps with the conversion rate.